LSD is the most powerful substance that the human being has ever developed for influencing the mind. I've used the comparison of nuclear energy or fissionable material. I think that in the right hands and scientific and disciplined and hopeful people, it will bring about change. Now, maybe it is insane to be against what's happening in this United States today. Maybe it's insane to try to have hope that something can be done about it. So if that's insane, count me in.
The Brotherhood of Eternal Love was existing at that time for about a year, I guess. They all were, you know, like bees without a hive, and they were looking for jobs. And where'd they find jobs? The city of Laguna Beach hired them to work in the Parks Department. The hell, these madmen were working in the Park Department, and they started getting these houses over in what John Griggs started to call it Dodge City.
The vibe was a truly very loving thing. You know, I had heard about, you know, Griggs wanted to get an island and all this stuff. I said, I could only imagine buying into that. Because I thought it was a pretty neat deal the way it was there.
The hash was at this house, and the pot was at this house, the LSD was at that house. But you could go to any of those houses and everybody, you know.
Well, I'll have to run over to the red house and get it for you.
I think these are times where, if we're going to survive, on a very large scale, we have to stop acting blindly, you know, acting by impulse and on an ego level, and investigate what we really need as a whole being and act in accordance to the needs of the species, rather than what TV tells you that you ought to be. And mostly in terms of what you consume and what you can afford and what you own. And acid definitely does that.
The Brotherhood of Eternal Love was not just a group of people. I mean, in the beginning, it was a very small group of mostly surfers from Laguna Beach, and it became a kind of a church that operated out of they called themselves a church that operated out of Mystic Arts World, which was a head shop essentially.
So I remember we met at the Taco Bell, which is still there, and I said, "Lil, why don't you come, you know, stay with me for a while?" And she had already been down to Mystic Arts World and took me down there, and that was the beginning of meeting the whole Brotherhood.
And we had a big gang of people that all attended, well, most of us attended Orange Coast College. And we kind of had a close-knit group that was there every day.
They were different. You know, they were the hippies, but they had a lot of pot, and they had a lot of drugs. It was, they fed off of certain things JG and some of the locals had that they wanted, and vice versa. These guys had certain things that some of the older guys wanted.
One ironic thing about Laguna Beach being such a hippie haven is that it was right next door to San Clemente, which was right next door to Camp Pendleton, the Marine base. San Clemente was also headquarters to the Western White House, which was a big kind of vacation house for Richard Nixon.
Laguna became the center of the psychedelic world for a while there, and they didn't like it. The powers that be didn't want to be known for that.
As South Vietnamese forces become stronger, the rate of American withdrawal can become greater. I have not and do not intend to announce the timetable for our program.
The political atmosphere in the latter part of the 60s was divisive in the extreme. The conflict in Vietnam was going on, and it became more and more polarizing. And the psychedelic revolution, such as it was, occurred within the context of this terrible Southeast Asia war that was going on.
Not a lot of us really believed in the war, you know, because we thought we were infiltrating someone else's space and trying to tell them how to live life, you know, like we knew it all, you know. And the LSD kind of gave me a consciousness that I could actually experience. We kind of made it available to as many people as we could, because we thought this was the way we would find peace on Earth.
We saw a vision of how we could help change the world. We felt we were the anointed ones.
The greatest pushers in this country today are the missionaries who make and distribute LSD, because they are convinced that it's a wonderful way, as that poisonous, evil man, Dr. Timothy Leary, has said. It is a way to turn on, tune in, and drop out.
People like Timothy Leary that were attracting a huge amount of attention from the United States government, because they were preaching a message that people didn't have to go along with this. But you had Timothy Leary telling every young person to just basically drop out of society. You had people that didn't necessarily care so much about the politics as just not wanting to have anything to do with it. It was a mass cultural defection.
So you think you can tell heaven from hell, blue skies from pain?
People were kind of, at least in the beginning, idealizing what was going on.
You know, you'd count 1,000 of them, you put them in a bag, and you count another 1,000. And, you know, being a kid, this guy'd get 1,040 because I get tired of counting the crap, you know.
Because there was just no end of people that wanted to buy drugs, and it was very easy to arrest untold numbers of hippies every day just by making it available.
You know, I started bringing in marijuana really early in my life. You know, I got connections in Tijuana to start with, you know. I was paying $15 a kilo, you know, bringing it back over here and selling it for $30 a kilo.
And the lengths that the cops went to try to get at the Brotherhood was almost comical. Purcell had a reputation for dressing up in drag or wearing long hair to look like a hippie. And
the brothers were really, really good at taking cars apart and knowing how to panel and do that, which you couldn't do today ever. And hollowing out surfboards, going on surf trips and hollowing out, bringing back surfboards to sell. They were very ingenious.
So the next thing you know is I was, you know, became at pushing 15, starting to develop a clientele for selling these kilos.
Other people started coming in because the Brotherhood was there, and there was a tremendous amount of dealing going on. There were a couple of, two or three syndicates going there, and they all were in a loose confederation.
It was really the wild, wild west. I mean, Laguna Canyon now has million-dollar mansions, but back then these were basically clapboard shacks. It was just a natural kind of fortress for the Brotherhood. I mean, they couldn't have picked a better spot than Laguna Canyon to base their operations. So they were hanging out in shacks, printing Orange Sunshine tablets by the thousands, and the cops were busy busting hippies down on, you know, PCH.
Purcell and Babcock would sit in their little... They had this little Chevy Nova. They would actually just sit out there on the frontage road there, Canyon Road, and watch cars coming in and out, because it was a Dodge City, one way in, one way out.
All right. Right here is where the Learys stopped their car and got out and ran down the path to John Griggs' house and left the doors open. Purcell came and found the pot in the back seat and busted it. This is the spot. The feel of the neighborhood hasn't changed. It's just like it was.
It really was a time that I look back now and I feel so blessed that I was able to be part of that experience with the Brotherhood. We all were a family, the original, you know, group, and very much took care of each other and loved each other and learned with each other and experienced with each other.
I was 14, you know, and it was, certainly wouldn't classify myself as a hippie. I just liked to surf. Played, you know, Babe Ruth Little League, you know, and just kind of being a 14-year-old.
I've been out of touch. I haven't taken any chemicals for years and years. Do I feel like I'm a better, more normal person now? I don't know. I suppose I'm better adapted to society, but I also feel like just fill in the hole. I've been dead for 25 years.
Well, my name is Robert Tierney, a.k.a. Stubby, and I was part of the Brotherhood in the 60s. And I've gone by many names.
This was a famous house in the 60s. There was a wild procession of persons that came and went out of this property.